yet, dear ones, we continue to tell you that you are in charge of that which you believe as truth. But you have empowered an illusion to become your reality, and so you must work to dispel, work to understand, work to overcome this illusion within you. And so it takes work. And so, dear ones, it takes faith. Faith in the power of yourself that you may not be able to yet see, that you may not be able to yet know. It takes, dear one, faith that you are one with the creative source of all life, that you have been given the power to co-create along with all life everywhere, and that you have an untapped potential that you are awakening more fully in each and every moment. It takes faith, dear ones, trust in something you cannot yet see manifest in your life, but that which you know is real. It takes faith, dear ones, to trust the deeper knowing within your heart, the deeper knowing of your soul. And that faith, dear one, that faith simply asks that you honor your own inner knowing more fully, that you place your attention upon your heart, where this deeper knowing exists within you, and you take your attention out of your mind, which holds within it thoughts of confusion, thoughts of disempowerment, thoughts, dear one, that are causing your suffering. And so, dear one, do not place your awareness within your mind and fight with the thoughts of disempowerment. For this, dear one, simply creates more suffering and more chaos, more confusion and more pain. Do not, dear ones, fight with your mind to try to change it. Instead, dear ones, honor your heart, for your heart has the power to dissolve these thoughts of suffering. Your heart, dear one, has the power to change your mind from a core level. For as we look at the energetic expression of the human mind, we understand, dear one, that it rises first within the area of the chest, rising up from unconsciousness into consciousness in the area of the face. And so, dear ones, the source of your mind is within your heart. It is from where the soul first enters into the body that the mind is being created. And so, dear ones, we ask you to focus upon your heart, for that brings more of your soul's energy into your subconscious and unconscious mind to bring awareness therein, to awaken that which you cannot yet know, but that which you will know as it is awakened more fully. For it is unconscious, but waiting to be birthed forth. For this, dear one, is the higher potential of you. It is existing within you. It is existing as you. And so, dear ones, we say, put your attention within and uncover that which you do not yet know, but that which will become known as you. And so, dear ones, you have asked, how can I better live in harmony with this world? How can I better live in harmony with my own soul? And what we say, dear one, is stop. Stop living from a socially conditioned mind that causes suffering, and start living as your soul in manifestation. And you will find, dear ones, a new perspective on life. You will find, dear ones, your life radically transformed as you are now living from a higher place within your embodiment, as you are now living more as yourself. And then, dear ones, it is a process of learning. Of learning to understand the thoughts that exist within your mind and the knowing that exists within your heart. You will feel how the energy of your soul in expression changes based upon your decisions of manifestation. It is simple, dear ones. Your soul is an expression of energy, an expression of creative power. And so as you become more familiar with this, you will understand what decisions you make that cause this energy of love and life to grow within you, to fill you, to flow more strongly. And you will understand, dear ones, which thoughts, which decisions, which actions, which judgments cause this energy to shrink, to become less than, to become weaker, to not flow as fully. And so, dear one, it is simply learning to maintain your awareness upon this field of infinite love and life energy of your soul, and understanding when you are following its guidance, and when you are following the knowing, and when you are following the thoughts within your mind, and when you are following the thoughts of someone else within your environment. It is simply the knowing, dear one, that you will give yourself as you stay connected to the self within, learning to honor it, learning to live from it, learning as it teaches you.